On the occasion of 140th birth anniversary of Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, subsequently the finance minister announced the initiative in budget speech of 2016 and 17. The objective of this program is to create environment which promotes learning between states by sharing best practices, experiences, and to foster the sense of common identity by showcasing rich culture and heritage, and to promote the spirit of national integration and to strengthen the fabric of emotional bonds between the people of our country. So to start with, for the first participant, I call Atharv Ranjan.
Namaskar. Today, I, Atharv Ranjan Sharma, of class 6th, will be writing a poem by Assami poet Hiren Bhattacharya. The topic of my poem is My Land and Others. So the poem is like this. I don't need a mandate for my land, while thousand of stallion gallop within my boiling blood. Let my words march. Let they be sentinels of cruel, vengeful nights. Let the swords of resistance shine for eternity as garrulous words pour through my veins. My shirt implodes, my breath grows heavier. The abyss become unstable, unbearable, like the hand placed with fish in shallow water. I am surrounded by the scheming hand of death, or by the concealed whiff of that defying flare. Thank you.
Ma'am, your mic is mute.
Second participant is Aradhya Maharshi from class 6th A.
Namaskar everyone. Today, I, Aradhya Maharshi, student of class 6th A, is going to recite a poem written by Hiren Bhattacharya. He is a renowned Assamese poet. The topic of my poem is To Those Killed at March. So, let's start. These flames, I lit them. Mother, I know. These flames will light up the allure of the world on your sick face. So I lit these flames. Day after day, at the breeze of the dawn, after every night, why do you sing me a lullaby? Mother, I still don't know. Don't hurt me with your spiteful mercy. For you, mother, I have sacrificed the blood of many loved ones. Now it's my enchanted body. Today I'm elated as I pay the dues of my birth. So I lit the flames. Thank you.
Ma'am, your mic is mute.
Now I welcome Suhani Vijay of class 6th B.
Namaskar to honorable teachers and my fellow mates. Today, I, Suhani Vijay of class 6th B, is going to present a poem in front of you all. And the title of my poem is Unviable Translation. So, let's start it. On any pretext, I may move away. Anywhere I wish to. Ma'am, sorry, ma'am, may I start again? Thank you, ma'am. Namaskar to honorable teachers and my fellow mates. Today, I, Suhani Vijay of class 6th B, is going to present a poem in front of you all. And the title of my poem is Unviable Translation. So, let's start it. On any pretext, I may move away anywhere I wish to, on any pretext. Of your company, I'll move away on any pretext. Clearing the path of excellence, this presence of yours. This presence of yours. In the halo of shadows, probed by solitude, I'll move, defies translation, I'll move away stealthily. By this poem, the poet is trying to tell us that nothing is impossible in this world if we will try our 100% and if we will try our best. The name of the poet is Haran Bhattacharya. Thank you.
Thank you, Suhani. Very well conveyed the message by the poet that nothing is impossible in life. And this is what we are doing. Yes? Very good, Suhani. Now, I invite Siddharth Singh from class 6B.
Namaskar. My name is Siddharth Singh. I am from class 6B. I am going to recite a poem named The Land and Others, written by Hiren Bhattacharya. It was never simple to border the land and preserve that land of pain, and neither a broad option that caused my hand a twirl, my body a stiff wreck, and my mouth a northward curve. And I required the help the most, more than the land itself, eclipsed the only flower, and the world broke into continents, a world now in which I must live. Thank you.
Give him a round of applause. Very good, Siddharth. And the next participant is Vihan Bhatt from class 6C.
Namaskar. I am Vihan Bhatt from class 6C. Today I am going to narrate an Assamese poem written by Dr. Nirmal Prabha Bordoloi. The title of my poem is Ishor Kot Nuthake. Ishor Kot Nuthake. Ishor Kot Nuthake. Ishor Thake Nukors. Ishor Thake Nukors. Nina Khakors. Ishor Thake Niki Bol Bol Tinos. Ishor Thake Niki Bol Fulloring Notes. Ishor Ase Niki Prutima Burots. Janivor Bonja Ekotke Utake. Teva Mat Deke Nidhi Utte Ukke. Hoshor Yon Te U. Hokonuke Deke Terange Bu. Ishor Kot Nuthake. Ishor Kot Nuthake. By this poem, the author is given the message that the God is everywhere. Thank you.
Very good, Vihan. We all were there in Assam, in the nature, and enjoying the Assamese food. Very good, Vihan. And the message is also worth giving, that God lives everywhere. Very good. Clapping for Vihan and every participant. Very good. Now I welcome Arunima from class 6C.
Namaskar to one and all present here. Today, I, Arunima of class 6C, is going to present a poem in front of you all. The title of my poem is To Those Killed at the March. The poem of this poem is Hiren Bhattacharya. These flames, I lit them. Mother, I know. These flames will light up the allure of the world on your sick face. So I lit these flames day after day at the breeze of the dawn. After every night, why do you sing me a lullaby? Mother, I still don't know. Don't hurt me with your spiteful mercy. For you, mother, I have sacrificed the blood of many a loved ones. Now, it is my enchanted body. Today, I am elated as I pay the dues of my birth. So today, I lit the flames. Thank you.
Very good, Arunima. Well versed. Now I invite Ankit Rathore from class 6D.
Namaskar. Namaskar to all of you. My name is Ankit Rathore. I am of class 6D. Today I am going to recite a poem. Title of the poem is O Mor Apunar Desh. It is written by Lakshminath Bezbarua. So the poem is like this. O Mor Apunar Desh. O Mor Sikuni Desh. Ene Khon Khuola. Ene Khon Kufola. এনে খন মোরো মোর দেশ, ও মোর কুড়িয়া মাত, ও মোর খুও দিমাত, পৃথিবীর কতু বিচারি জনম তু নুপুয়া করিলেও পাত, ও মোর উপজাথায়, ও মোর আহমি আয়, চাইলো এবার মুখমি তোমার হেপা মোর পলবা নায়। থ্যাংক ইউ।
Very good, Ankit. So all the poets, whether they are defining nature, whether they are defining the God's presence between us, they are always appreciating the beauty provided to us by God. And now I invite the last participant of this activity, Lakshita Bansal from class 6th D.
Namaskar. Today I, Lakshita Bansal of class 6th D, is going to narrate a poem which is written by Hiren Bhattacharya, and the title of the poem is What Is It That Burns In Me? So let's start. What is it that burns in me, that swells? The agony and the ecstasy, my heart. In all my senses hums the tune of your love, burns intensely that saturates with ash. Inside and out of my heart, maybe the colloquialism of your love will incinerate me in a slow pace. Thank you.
Very good, Lakshita. Very good, all of you, for taking the initiative of reciting the poem by Assamese author. Very well versed. Very good, all of you. Now I invite Srimati Sakshi Sharma to say a few words for appreciation for all the participants.
Namaskar, everyone.
Namaskar, ma'am.
I really congratulate all the efforts of all these tiny ones, especially the one who, made the extra effort of learning Assamese in such a short notice. I don't know how they, maybe thanks to Google also, I should say that they could learn the other language in such a less time. But efforts of all need to be appreciated. And activities like this, I believe it gives us an opportunity to come into contact with the culture of a different state, although we belong to the same country, but there's a vast, vast difference. We have heard so much about Assam, many of us maybe, although I have not been, I've heard about it, but maybe many of us have been to this place as well. But reading about the authors or the poets of that particular place and knowing about the meaning of those poems and reciting them, somewhere I believe the purpose of these activities is bringing oneness in the nation. Moreover, the more you read about them, the more you understand their culture and the love and the feeling of oneness generates in everyone. When I was listening to the poems of all these students, I could feel the heroism and that feeling of patriotism which these poets had. I don't know how much these students also bothered to find out the meaning. I'm sure they must have done that. But then if you have not, then I would suggest all these students to even try to find out what is the meaning of these poems, so that they would understand that what actually the poet is trying to convey. Poem recitation, if we talk about it, gives you a feel like we enjoy listening to music, like we enjoy listening to these songs, and it refreshes you, it transcends you to a new place altogether. Similarly, when it comes to poems, those of you who are fond of writing some poetry, any piece of writing, it is the best way to express your feelings. And poem recitation is how do you modulate your voice. I believe a little more work in that would help you to recite your poems well. And modulation, along with the modulation, the correct pronunciation, And I believe if you understand the meaning of this poem, modulation and not pronunciation exactly, but yes, modulation definitely comes. The problem of modulation is only when we don't understand the meaning. We are only reading it out, so that can be a problem. But once you understand the gist of it, what the poet or the author is exactly talking about it, that feeling that automatically comes in, right? So once again, I would like to appreciate the efforts of all the students and the teacher in charge as well, who in such a short time could organize such a beautiful activity. And we actually, as Pallavi ma'am was speaking in between, we were like transcended to Assam altogether. We could smell the we could smell the air of Assam in your poems. And thank you for such a beautiful, nice, meaningful session, I should say. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for appreciating all the tiny thoughts. And thank you, everybody, for participating in the activity. Thank you very much. So here we conclude for the day.